Okay, welcome students. Today we are going to start with the brittle coating methods. That is the fifth module. In that brittle coating methods, still now we have completed four modules. So all those four modules are very important for exam purpose, and this fifth module is also very important. Okay, so myself Viresh Kumar KS. Let's start with the topics. Okay, so first going to see what are the things which are in here. We have to understand brittle coating. So what is this brittle? What is the meaning of brittlety? So brittlety is nothing but it's a hard components. If you want, it doesn't give any yielding. Okay, so what happens, if you apply any load on the brittle materials, it will get crack, but it will take lot of load, but even though it doesn't give any yieldings, okay, it doesn't give any plastic deformations, it directly give a crack. There is a crack generation, by that the material is going to fail. So in here, brittle coating method is nothing but we are using the material which is pasted on the material, and it is, when it is cured, it will be acting as a brittle. Okay, so if you just apply some load on that, whatever the coating, when it is solidified, it will give you the crack, it will not get any elongations. Okay, so that is the brittle material which is used for the brittle coating methods. You can see here the principle of stress analysis involves the adherence of a thin coating, brittle in nature, on the surface of the specimen. When the specimen is subjected to external loads, so the thin brittle coating cracks under the tensile stress. So it is the thing which is happens in here. So in here, we are going to apply a thin coating over the surface. By that, we are going to apply the load that may be a tensile. So what happens, because of that load, it will give some cracks. So by analyzing that cracks, we will understand what is the stress in that material. Okay, the strain produced in a specimen is transmitted to the coating, resulting in coating cracks. That is the thing which happens. From the threshold strain of the coating, that is minimum strain required to cause the coating to crack, determined through calibration of coating, the stress in the specimen as determined. Means if you want to determine the threshold of strain, okay, so what happens, you are going to, earlierly you are making a calibration of that cracking, means for particular amount of load this material is going to crack. Okay, so like that you have made it the calibration. So similarly, if you apply on the any materials, so it will get crack for such a certain amount of threshold strain. So that strain is calibrated, you know the what is the value of that. So by that you understand what is the amount of stress developed in the material. Let's see, the behavior of the coating is quite complicated, as it depends on number of parameters influencing the behavior of the coating. Means it has some parameters which is going to affect on its behavior. Okay, so first one is coating thickness. Okay, coating thickness, if you apply the higher thicker amount of coating, then what happens, the crack may generate at various application of load. But if you apply thin coating, okay, so one of the behavior is the crack coat thickness. Next, the coating temperature. So coating temperature means, so particular whatever the material which is coated on the surface, it have some temperature limits. If the temperature limits exceeds, it will lose its property. So that's why it is also going to affect. Creep in the coating during testing. Means what happens, if any creep which is occurs in the coating during testing, it is also going to affect the determination of stress in the material. Then moisture. So some coating materials may absorb the moisture, or may it is going to have the limitation of moisture. So what happens, with respect to the moisture content, it is going to affect the behavior. The velocity of the airflow over the coating. even though some of the materials which are used where the airflow is high in a high velocity. So that velocity is also going to affect the behavior of a whatever the coating material, curing time of a coating. So curing time is also one of the important parameter, because if it is solidifies quickly, you can test more whatever the components. If it will take lot of time, then it is difficult to make the testings. So the curing time is also going to matters. Load time history. Load time history is nothing but the amount of loading at a different amount of time. So what happens? That is also going to affect the behavior of a coating materials. The use of coating is limited to identify the regions of high stress and regions of low stresses. Okay, actually what happens in the coating type of method, we are maximumly use this type of method to understand where is the stress is high and where is the stress is low. Okay, in those regions only we are going to consider this type of whatever the coating method. This technique is providing simple and direct approach for solving large class of industrial problems such as pressure vessels. This type of whatever the coating is mainly used in the pressure vessels for to determine its high pressure, high stresses and low stresses in that pressure vessels. This technique has been used for to determine the stress concentration in components subjected to various types of loads. That is the one technique used for that. The measurement of thermal and residual strains in the component. So that is also important. Thermal means because of thermal application, there is a stresses and there is a stress development occurs that can be determined. And residual strains are nothing but the strains which are trapped inside the material when it is under forced forming process. So the in that process there may be a chances of residual stresses. We can also determine the type of stresses. Providing the whole field data for the magnitude and direction of principal stresses means it will provide the whole field data for the magnitude and direction of principal stresses. This method is based upon the perfect adhesion of thin coating, brittle in nature, on the surface of a component to be analyzed for stresses. So what happens? This method is mainly there is one condition, means adhesion should be perfect. Okay. And the particular paste which is used, it should have the brittle nature. Okay, this is very important in this type of coating method. When the specimen is stressed, the surface strains of a specimen are transmitted to the coating, and the coating cracks in the direction perpendicular to the maximum tensile principal stresses. Okay, so you can see here, read once again. When the specimen is stressed, you can understand here, the specimen is stressed, the surface strains of the specimen are transmitted, means the surface strains on a specimen are transmitted to the coating, and the coating cracks in the direction perpendicular to the maximum tensile principal stresses. Okay, the coating cracks which are going to be in this such a direction that it should be a perpendicular, should make the inclination of perpendicularity with the maximum tensile principal stresses. So some of the advantages which are considered in the brittle coating. It is nearly a whole field stress analysis technique, so it can be used for the whole field. The technique can be directly applied to the prototype of actual machine, means it can be applied directly to the machine components in the operation, means it is in a dynamic condition, it is in the operation condition, and there is no necessity of for any model. In our earlier steps, so we are considering one model, and for that we are applying some stress and we are determining the stresses for that. Okay. So like that we are making, but in here there is no need of model. Analysis of converting the data into stress in the component is not complicated. Since it is very simple, the CACs are very, it is easily calibrated earlier. Just by appearance of that cracks, we can easily determine the stresses. Disadvantages. The behavior of a coating is strongly depending on temperature and humidity variation during testings. The temperature and humidity is also one of the factors which is affecting the coating behavior. Number of variables affecting the sensitivity of coating, therefore the behavior of coating has to be properly understood. Okay, so there are a lot of variables which is affecting, so it is also sensitive for some different parameters, so you have to be properly understood to determine the stresses by using this method. This technique is more qualitative in nature than quantitative. Means you can't apply for a complete model, but in a particular area, the amount of quality means you can get the quality output, quality result at a particular area, then quantitative. So it can be used for the qualitative analysis. So let's move on to the coating stresses. Okay. So coating stresses is just a matter and topic which will give the understanding how the coating stresses are related to the stresses which are develops in the material. Okay. So the coating stresses. See here, we are taking one model. Okay. So this is the bottom which is the, it is a specimen which is given in here. This is a specimen. The top layer which is hatched, which is called as coating. Okay. So this is specimen and this above layer is a coating. The layer is very thin. Above layer is very thin. So what happens? The stresses developed in this stress and strain which is developed in this specimen is taken as sigma 1s, sigma 2s. The S represents surface. Sigma 1s, sigma 2s. And this strains are taken as epsilon 1s and epsilon 2s. These are the strains and stresses of a specimen. If you go to the coating, this will be for the coating stresses, it is sigma 1c. The c represent coating layer and sigma 2c, it is the coating layer. So these are the principal stresses in the coating. And similarly, if you see this or the whatever the strains, so it is also epsilon 1c and epsilon 2c. These are the coating stresses strains which are develops in the coating material. Okay, so in here we have given epsilon 1c is equal to epsilon 1s because the strains which are developed in the specimen is equal to the strains which are developed in the coating because we are having the perfect bonding of layer with the specimen. So that perfect bonding will results in the equal amount of strains develops in both specimen and a coating. Okay, it's just a loading application, we are just applying some load. So because on applying the load on a specimen, there is a coating on here. You can see the cracks which are generated. So the larger crack which are generated when there is a more stress, and the smaller cracks which are generated where there is a less stress. So by that we can understood the variation of stresses at different points. Okay, this is the cracks which are generated on the surface when the specimen is under load. Okay. We are applying the, we are taking cantilever beam where the load is applied. So you can also see here sigma 1 and sigma 2 are the principal stresses in specimen, epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 are the principal strains in specimen, sigma 1c, sigma 2c are principal stresses in coating, epsilon 1c and epsilon 2c are the principal strains in specimen, sorry it's not specimen, it's coating, it's mistaken, and nu c and nu s, it's nothing but Poisson's ratio of coating and specimens respectively. And epsilon C and epsilon S are Young's models of coating and specimen respectively. Okay. So now move on to the some derivation regarding this whatever the coating stresses. Consider the specimen and the coating is as shown in figure. Okay. We are considering the specimen by Hooke's law. We know the Hooke's law where the strain is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 nu S nu into sigma 2 by E. This is the Hooke's stress. Okay, Hooke's law equation on a strain. So we are using that strain equation for the specimen strain, that is epsilon 1s which is equal to sigma 1s minus nu s sigma 2s by epsilon s. So this is the strain develops in one direction in the specimen. So S represents the specimen, okay, our surface. Next, this epsilon 2 is another direction strain where sigma 2s minus nu s sigma 1s by epsilon s. This is the another equation. Then if you see the coating strength is also equal since we have equated the both sigma 1c and sigma 1s are similar because of the perfect bonding. So sigma 1s, sorry, epsilon 1s and epsilon 1c are equal because of the perfect bonding. So the equation is epsilon 1c is equal to sigma 1c minus nu c by nu c into sigma 2c by epsilon ec. Similarly, epsilon 2c is equal to sigma 2c minus nu c sigma 1c by epsilon c. So like that the equations are going to be taken for the specimen and for the coating. So what we do, we have considered here the perfect adhesion behavior between the coating and surface. So we consider it as epsilon 1c is equal to epsilon 1s and epsilon 2c is equal to epsilon 2s. We are equating the both equations, then the equation will be like this: sigma 1c minus nu c sigma 2c by ec, which is equal to sigma 1s minus nu s sigma 2s by epsilon es. So this is equation 1. Similarly, we equated the epsilon 2c and epsilon 2s in this equation. Thus, solving the equation 1 and 2, we get, when we solve that equation, we will get the sigma 1c value. Okay. Since we have to determine the stresses in the coating, what is the coating stresses? Means if you understand the stresses in the coating, then you can easily determine the stresses in the surface. So first we require the equation of this sigma 1s. So sigma 1c. So if you solve this equation on equation 2, we will get this type of solved equation, that is sigma 1c is equal to ec by es 1 minus nu c square. In the bracket 1 minus nu c nu s whole sigma 1s minus nu c minus nu s whole sigma 2s. So similarly, sigma 2c is equal to ec by es 1 minus nu c square into 1 minus nu c nu s into sigma 2s minus nu c minus nu s sigma 1s. This is the equation you are going to get by solving the equation 1 and 2. So finally, if you just you can take the difference of the sigma 1c and sigma 2c, that is sigma 1c minus sigma 2c is equal to ec by es 1 plus nu s 1 plus nu c into sigma 1s minus sigma 2s. This is very important equation, that is third equation. From the equation we can say that sigma 1c minus sigma 2c always has the same sign as sigma 1s minus sigma 2c 2s. To calibrate the coating, a cantilever calibration strip as shown in figure 2, we have shown that figure. The calibration is used to determine the strain sensitivity. So we are making the calibration in here, so determine the strain sensitivity. The strain at A where the crack starts appears is called strain sensitivity of the coating or threshold strain. The strains and the stresses at A in the coating produced by the external load are found by setting sigma 2s is equal to 0. Okay. What we can see here, we are applying the load at one direction. So stresses which are developed in only one direction. So what we can take only stresses in sigma 1s. Now we are not considering sigma 2s because the loading is in one direction. So that's why sigma 1s is having some value, but sigma 2s is equal to 0 in here. So the equations become sigma 1c and sigma 2c equations will be like this. The earlier equation, these two equations are converted into these two by considering sigma 2s is equal to 0. Okay. Thank you, students. We will discuss the next topic in the next classes. And this is very important derivation. Don't forget. It's very simple. Just you have to work out and understand the topic first of all. Then you can easily solve this. Okay. In the next class, we will start with the next part of the module. Thank you. If you have any queries, you can just ask me by using my contacts. Okay. Thank you.